My name is Daniel Marcellus Reed, and I'm 46 years old.
My name is Connor May, I'm 20 years old.
Jason Daniel Rhodes, 33.
Kevin Cunningham, and I'm 24 years old.
My name is Carl Bradley, and I'm 26 years old.
Stephen Jane Peters, 32 years old.
Kyle Large, 22.
John V. Hill, 36 years old.
My name is Grayson, I'm 23 years old.
My name is Keelan Rappert, I'm 44 years old.
I am Angie Pelfrey, and I'm 43.
I started doing drugs the summer of my freshman year.
How old was I?
12.
Sixth grade.
I was 12.
When I was 12 years old?
I was 12 years old.
My sophomore year of high school.
I was 12.
Oh, my parents separated when I was about 12.
Smoked weed, basically, until I was about 21. That's when I got into hard drugs and started going to raves and parties.
Took a drink of alcohol with a friend, and I liked it.
I smoked a blunt with my brother. Eric smoked a blunt with me.
So the first night I ever got drunk, I got high too.
Really, it was kind of just to fit in.
Like later on down the road, like the next year or something, I, you know, tried using prescription drugs,
and then like the first hardcore substance was a couple months later, and started smoking weed and smoking crack.
I was a registered nurse, and I was diagnosed with fibromyalgia. The prescription that I was getting after probably a year on taking the Percocet was over 200 pain pills a month. Throughout, because of my addiction, we lost our home, we lost our vehicles, we lost our business.
There was a period where I went it was probably about 6 months without even looking in the mirror. And one day I just did, and I didn't know who I was or what I became.
Quit being fun. I just got to the point where I was having more depression. It seemed like I was depressed all the time. I was using just to stay normal, and the amount I needed to stay normal was even more and more. I was just miserable.
I was homeless, wasn't seeing much of my son. I have a 3-year-old son, and I wasn't seeing much of him.
If I went any longer, I would end up either dead or in prison.
I started Freedom Hall after I got out of prison. In 2005, I had told my counselor, she said, what is one goal in your life? And I said, I want to help people that don't have insurance. I want to open our own place, that we can do this just to help people. So that's when we opened Freedom Hall.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear I first believed.
I remember my first day I went up here. I wasn't even sure if this place was the rehab or not. And I remember walking up, and they have the sewage like right next door. So the first thing I smelled was poop. Walking up, and I seen a bunch of rednecks out in the front, and culture shock, to say the least. But, you know, I knew I had
couldn't be mad at anybody because I did it to myself, so I just made the best of it.
I remember walking up on the porch scared to death, afraid to see what was going to happen.
Dad drove me down here because he figured if he drives me down, I can't come back. You know, I don't have a car. So he drove me down and dropped me back off at my grandparents, and 2 weeks later, I was back here at Freedom Hall again. Angie took me back in. And life was just, after that, you know, life just completely did a 180.
Being here has allowed me not to be depressed. You know, if I was still out there using, I would still be mad at myself. I'd still be beating myself up.
My heart was like an onion. It had layers to it, and those were the walls that I built around it. And since I've been here, you know, it's layers have been peeling. I get emotions I forgot I even had or even wanted to have.
I mean, I've got a relationship with God, which I never thought would happen. I mean, before I came here in the church or anything like that, that just right there is a major change.
This is the best I've ever felt. This is the best I've ever done. I've already graduated this program. I'm just in the process of trying to really get hired on the Piketon recovery to start giving back to people who are free to give to me.
My third day here, I was clean, so I say 6.5 months.
Like about 10 months.
2 weeks, 13 months today.
Just since June the 21st of 2012.
76 days today.
I think I would do it all over again. If I had to. If I knew that it was going to save one life, I would do it again. I think my family would do it again. With loved ones close to me, shh, this is the remedy, and I got the recipe. I don't need no Hennessy. Yeah, it's been 9 months now. Haven't had a drink, and I'm starting to see clear now. I'm putting all my fears down. I can hear the cheers now. Seeing peace signs when I look around. Hey, young homie, what you tripping on? Looking at life like, how did I get it wrong? Life's too short, gotta live it long. To my brothers and sisters from where we get along. Hey, young homie, what you tripping on? Looking at life like, how did I get it wrong? Life's too short, gotta live it long. To my brothers and sisters from where we get along. Open up your eyes, look around. Homie, can you see how it's going down? Brothers locked up, sisters knocked up. If you wanna build your love up, put your hate down. Ooh, that's the only way to live. Turn the negatives to positives. It's gonna be alright, by Molly said. Fuck the dumb shit, keep it moving, that's what time it is. Hey, young homie, what you tripping on? Looking at life like, how did